We will have a brief Q&A at this time. We'll only be taking two questions at this time. However, there will be a longer session in a mixed zone format with the new national head coach for members of the media. So I saw some inquiring looks from the back, and you will have the opportunity to speak to him at that time. And that will be coordinated by the Director of Communications, Mr. Sean Fuentes, who is at the back of the room. But in terms of the brief Q&A at this time, if you do have a question, please put up your hand at this time, because there is a microphone being passed around so we can get your question for the benefit of the radio audience. So, any questions at this time? And we're represented by several members of the media here. Yes, we have one question up in front. And I'll let the young lady introduce herself.
Hi, Mandy Liverpool of Flow Sports. Tom, why do you think you're the right man to lead Trinidad and Tobago back to the World Cup?
Does this work? No, yeah, it works. Okay. There are a few factors for that. First of all, I think coaching is based on being a good coach. First of all, I think you're born as a good coach, that first of all. But then you have education and you have experience. And the combination of these factors, my experience to work for national team level in different situations, in different continents, to understand, to work with different cultures, makes me believing that I'm having a benefit to some other coaches. The other thing is, I'm a tactical coach. I have already a clear idea how I want to play, what my thoughts are, how to use the weaknesses of opponents and the strengths of our own team. I think it's very important to know what I can do. I have a decent track record and a lot of experience, and combined with all the quality what's here, because Trinidad and Tobago is a very good football nation. Quality on the pitch, quality on the side, with technical advice, with infrastructure, I believe that it's the right mix to achieve our goals.
Further question, there is one question at the back, TV6.
Yeah, I just want to find out the criteria.
Name please, just for benefit of radio audiences.
Okay, so Jill for TV6 Sport. Just want to find out the criteria used to select the coach for the national team.
Well, the question, the technical committee shortlisted a number of people. We had maybe 15, 20, 25 applications. They shortlisted four people, which they recommended that the TTFA talk to in a particular ranking order, and that was the criteria that was used. You could talk to them directly about what the criteria they used, and Tom came out on top insofar as he was not our first choice, for sure, but then he was also affordable as our second choice. Our first choice was way out of what we could afford it. And I make no apologies for saying that. And I can tell you who the first choice was as well.
Yeah.
Philip Trustier. And Tom knows that.
Yeah. We have time for one more question. Let's see, one more question. Sergio, I think, in fact, there's one next to you. Mr. Ravello.
Joe Ravello from Flow Sports. This is the highest FIFA ranked team that you're going to coach. No? Okay. What do you think that you can bring to this team then? Are you intimidated by the position that we're in, and what can you bring?
Yeah. I know I saw the media report where they wrote also
about
it. Yeah. I saw the media report also where it was written the highest team, but my imagination is that Togo was a little bit higher, and if you look even to the standard of players, like Adebayor and all top European-based players, I think it's same or even higher level. I don't think we have to look like that, because FIFA rankings are changing from one moment to the other. There are teams who don't play for 3 months and jump 20 positions. So I don't think we have to look at that. It's nice to be high in the FIFA ranking, but it are the results on the pitch what counts. And the fact is that the last 12 months, Trinidad didn't achieve the results what was necessary, what forced them into do a change. I was already in similar situations in different countries, even if they are 20 or 30 positions lower on the FIFA ranking, they also play football and they have players who play also in top clubs in Europe. And I think football is quite similar in a lot of countries in all over the world. It's very important to try to adapt as soon as possible to culture here, to talk to a lot of people, to observe a lot, and to start working very hard together to achieve that. I think if you are a coach of a club team in the local league here, or you are a coach of Manchester United, you have the same approach. You have to be a coach who maintains the tactical knowledge, the physical, the mental, the technical things. You have to be able to communicate with players, with media, and it doesn't matter which continent, which club or federation it is, a good coach must achieve on every level decent results. And it's even easier to work in a good federation or a good club with good players than on lower level where things most of the time are not well organized. So I'm now 20 years of a coach. I was not Ruud Gullit or not Diego Maradona, so I couldn't start with Holland or Argentina as a football player. So the way I had to walk up in the ranking is something I achieved because of my qualities. And the reason I'm here is because the Belgian Federation, for instance, recommended me here. I'm highly respected by one of the major football countries in this time of world football. Now it's my job to prove that on my birthday I'm still coach of Trinidad and Tobago, and to go to the World Cup. And that's, I'm convinced that we together can achieve that.
Right, thank you very much for your questions, ladies and gentlemen. We will have the opportunity to speak or have some more questions, pose some more questions to the new national men's senior team head coach, Mr. Tom Saintfiet, after the press conference. So just to remind you once again, that will be coordinated by the Director of Communications, Mr. Sean Quintus, who is on the right side of the room, and he will be talking to you more about that afterwards. We do have some light refreshments. They are outside by the swimming pool. I don't know if the TTFA got permission for you to use the pool. I suspect not. But the refreshments, all the same, are for you. So please join us in that. In the meantime, journalist, you do have the opportunity to speak to a new national coach right after. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Yes.
Yeah.
All right, we will get another take for the members of the electronic media just after.
Then I want to talk to